think that's actually a really hard question, because I think leadership means a lot of things to a lot of people. But for our purposes, when we're talking about helping professions and we're talking about early childhood, I always just like to keep it very simple and say that leaders are people who guide other adults. And maybe another way to sort of say it is that leaders hold the frame so that others can build. And so I think that's my general definition of a leader. I love the idea of resilient leadership. I think a resilient leader does everything a great leader does. I mean, there's lots of responsibilities involved with being a leader. But a resilient leader, as I said before, sort of holds the frame and holds the people who build. Because it's one thing to get the job done. It's another thing to care about the people who are doing the job and making sure that you're not just building a strong structure, but you're building a strong people that can build that structure again and again. So many, many years ago, the Devereux Center for Resilient Children created something called the DARS, which is the Devereux Adult Resilience Survey. And that was our effort to really look at the resilience of grownups who care for kids and families, who teach kids and families, who work with kids and families. And as we started to disseminate the information about adult resilience, we kept hearing folks say, well, I work in an environment that really supports my resilience, or I work in an environment that really doesn't support my resilience. So we started to think about workplace culture. And is it a culture of resilience? Are we creating environments, those holding environments where grownups can be resilient? And that really comes down to leadership. So we began to develop the Devereux Resilient Leadership Survey, and we really used the DARS as the backbone. So if we need healthy relationships, healthy initiative, healthy self-control, and healthy internal beliefs to be resilient as people, then as leaders, we need to be facilitating and fostering those protective factors in the folks that we care for. So the DURLS is a reflective checklist that helps leaders go, how am I building up the resilience of my teams? And that's really at the heart of what this tool is about. It's about helping leaders be really reflective about how they're building the resilience of their staff. It's a dream, right? And it's not that easy. It's always a work in progress. But if a leader is focusing on these protective factors of building resilience in their staff, we're gonna start to see it manifest in really healthy and functional workspaces. So if a leader's committed to building relationships in their team, I think the first thing we wanna do is imagine what happens when there aren't healthy relationships in a team. I think everyone knows what that looks like. There's backbiting and there's everyone sort of picking at each other and not willing to pitch in. But when we support connection and we support our staff in being able to build relationships and to see each other and all of each other and all of our humanness, we see people willing to give people benefit of the doubt. We see people willing to pitch in and have someone's back. We see more encouragement. We see more teaming. So we can go through all the protective factors. We look at relationships. If a leader is working on building the initiative of staff, again, wonder, what does it look like when staff don't have initiative, when our teams aren't using their initiative? And if they are, we're seeing them problem solve. They're not waiting for someone else to fix it. They're wanting to fix it. They feel ownership. They feel a part of the vision and mission of the organization. If we're building self-control, we see staff who are using healthy coping. And it's a part of the culture and part of the norms that we care about our well-being, that we care about our mental health, that we prioritize it, that we practice that as a team, we practice that as a culture, we practice that with kids and families as well. And then the last one, internal beliefs. What happens in a workplace where everyone's internal beliefs, their self-talk, is saying you're valuable, you're important, you matter, what you do matters. And when we have those healthy internal beliefs and everyone is feeling valued and their self-talk is constructive, you just feel that in the culture. And that brings us to this beautiful concept of called parallel process, where when we are resilient and we're doing good things as leaders for our staff, then our staff are able to give it to the people they serve, the little ones they serve, the families they serve, and we want to create that ripple effect. So the ability to focus on these things through the use of the Durals can really help us to create that ripple effect. I love the Resilient Leadership Training Series. It's one of my favorite things to do. I co-facilitate it with the incomparable Nefertiti Pointer. And I think part of what we model together is a culture of resilience. So when you are part of the class, you feel that. And it's a 6-part webinar series. And anyone is welcome if you consider yourself a leader. And remember, we define that as anyone who's guiding other adults. And so if you feel like you're holding structure so that other adults can build and be successful, you're welcome to be a part of this experience. And in this 6-part webinar series, you're going to join Nefertiti and I on a journey of reflection. We're going to go through the Durals bit by bit. We're going to show you how to pause and not rush through your lives. We're going to show you how to reflect. We're going to talk about how we then can really focus on specific things that will make a difference in our staff's resilience. And then we're going to talk about taking action on those things. And so we do this pause, reflect, focus, take action process for the 6 times we're together. And we leave you with a lot of great reflection, but a lot of great actionable steps that you can take into your leadership. So I hope folks leave with a good feeling, with a more optimistic perspective on how they can be effective in their leadership. But they also leave with concrete resources that they can revisit again and again, because building a resilient culture is not a one and done. It's not a box you check. It's an ongoing process. And so we give you the tools to continue to engage in resilient leadership after our time is done. Hang in there is the first message. But I think one of the things we talk about a lot when we talk about resilient leadership is the ripple effect that we want to pour into our staff, so our staff can pour in to kids and families. But we also have to start with ourselves. And in the Resilient Leadership Series, we spend a good first chunk of our time talking about leaders' resilience, your own resilience, because you can't give what you don't have. And so I want all leaders to know that while you wake up every day ready to pour into your staff and hold the frame for folks, that you also need to pour into yourself and get support for holding up your own frame and to take care of your own resilience, because we cannot give what we do not have.